On October 9th, 2013, in Allentown, Pennsylvania, Darren Booth grabs a snack in preparation for the season finale of his favorite TV show. Darren settles in for the ride, but just as they are about to announce the winner, he is suddenly left in the dark. Darren frantically tries to get the power back on. But is unsuccessful, having run out of options, and with moments to spare before the big reveal, Darren makes a desperate call.
Police 911, can I help you?
Yeah, I was watching America's Got Talent, and then the power went out. The power went out.
Yeah,
on my TV.
The transformer blew.
Yeah. I'm watching my TV show.
That's not my problem, sir.
Dispatch centers become very busy during power outages. People get stuck in elevators. They get panicky. But missing your television show?
I'm watching my TV show. That's not my problem, sir.
I can't help you.
I'm watching America's Got Talent, and the power went out. And I paid my electric bill.
Sir.
I paid my electric bill on time.
About your cable going out.
My first impression when I heard this call is, OMG. Did you really just call 911 because you're missing America's Got Talent? America's Got Crazy.
The power goes out, and his first call is not to the electric company, it's not to the cable company, it's to 911.
The dispatcher is unable to persuade Darren this is not an emergency.
Sir,
I watched America's Got Talent.
I was watching my TV show.
So power outages are serious. I mean, there could be so many things that happen. Traffic lights go out, and then there are people at home who are on certain machines that they need the power for. But then you hear he's upset because he's missing his favorite TV show.
And must hang up to take other 911 calls.
This is not a police problem. This is not an emergency. It's a TV show. If you want to figure out who won, look on the internet or talk to a friend. Your concern about your TV set is a very low priority.
Moments later, the power returns. But it's too late. Darren's favorite show of all time has ended.
On a daily basis, we do deal with callers who are frustrated, and they maybe tend to take it out on us, and they get a little irritated and irate. But it's our job to at least try to calm them down and let them know that we are trying to provide them with the best help we can. So if the power happens to go out during the grand finale of your favorite TV show, don't call 911. Catch a rerun.
On June 4th, 2013, just outside Burlington, Vermont, Carol Spearson drives down a familiar stretch of country road. But a slow-moving vehicle is headed towards her in the wrong lane. Carol quickly swerves to avoid a head-on collision. The accident is avoided, but Carol sees something at the wheel of the oncoming vehicle that leads her to call 911.
911.
Yeah, there's a little boy driving a car down on Grove Road, and he about hit me. Little boy driving a car was going the wrong way.
Earlier that day, Nicholas Lee is at his grandmother's house.
Hi, sweetie. Time to put things away now.
But while Grandma lends a hand, Nicholas becomes disinterested and slips out of the room. From there, things quickly spin out of control.
Little kids are very perceptive, you know? All he needs to know how to do is to put that car into drive, and then you have a moving vehicle. And he's not only a danger to himself, but he's a danger to whoever else is around.
Now, Nicholas is alone and behind the wheel of a moving vehicle. A patrol car responds to the 911 call.
I see a police car right here. Okay, can you flag down the officer and tell him where it is then?
There's a little boy driving a car right up here. He about hit me.
An SUV can do a lot of damage. It can go into another vehicle or go into a business or a residence. So this is something law enforcement is going to take very seriously.
The officer also calls 911 dispatch.
911.
Yeah, I'm following a little kid on Grove Road driving a car.
Okay, hold on.
You don't have an adult at the wheel of the car, so it's not really a crime in progress. It's not somebody that we're going to use some pursuit intervention techniques to stop.
Hold on just a second. I got it.
Wait a minute, boy. Wait a minute.
Are you driving that?
I'm driving by my mom's car.
I got it stopped. He's about 4 years old. He's driving.
Okay, hang on. I'll get a deputy over there.
All right.
Nicholas is returned to his very relieved grandmother. No charges are filed.